conferences in all of college football. Death Valley, Clemson, South Carolina, home to the Tigers since 1945. Little gets the blood boiling. White like a rivalry game. Barbs, shots, trash talk, things that go on throughout the week will now all be settled on this field. As we'll see the number 22 team in the country, the NC State Wolfpack, taking on the 17th ranked team in the land, the Clemson Tigers. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. NC State will kick off, and that'll get things underway. He'll start the return inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. So the Clemson Tigers offense is on the field for the first time today. These rivalry games can really get the blood pumping, and we'll see who can manage their emotions best early.
Everyone's been waiting for this game, right? You know, both of these teams have had this game circled all the way back to the beginning of the offseason, so you got to be able to play under control.
With passion, with energy, with hatred, because it's a rivalry game, but keep your emotions in check and making sure I'm controlling what I can control.
After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line, 2nd and 7. From the gun, running back gets to give. On the move at the 30. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
It was a really nice play there. The thing I like about this guy, too, his versatility. He's not just good running the ball, but he can catch and he can block. And you think about all the greats they've had at the position in recent years. Versatility at the running back position, being an every down back. And that's exactly what this guy embodies.
The sure hands, it's Haynes. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down. They've done a really good job identifying mismatches, and they find one out of the backfield there.
Reese, I really don't think it's that hard. My guy is better than yours. Find the matchup across the field. Running back's got some speed. Get it in his hands quickly. Throw it to him fast. Let him make somebody miss against a slower guy that's usually a linebacker.
Pulls it in. It's Brown. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down.
Tell you what, that's great execution between the QB and receiver. They look like they could execute that throw in their sleep. Quarterback took his steps, threw it on time. Great route by the receiver. Nice job securing the catch.
The Tigers will snap it on 1st and 10. Making sure they have good balance, keeping it on the ground. Didn't get much done on that run. He'll fight his way out and maybe pick up a yard. I know you want to prepare for every game the same way, but there's just something different about rivalry games, Jesse.
It's because, Reese, I think players are aware that games like this define your legacy as a player. Your record in rivalry games is something that people are going to talk about for years and years down the road. You have got to show up and play your best football in games like this.
And a great job by the QB, finding the running back, getting the football where he can do some damage after the catch, and most importantly, get the first down.
Just on the edge of the red zone, 1st and 10 from the 21. Leaves it with the running back. He breaks a tackle. He's knocked down in the backfield, a swarming defense, and he'll lose 7.
Listen, I know there are a lot of DBs out there that all they want to do is get interceptions and dance in the end zone. This dude likes to put his face in the fan, get close to the line of scrimmage, and tackle. And on the opening drive that he's out there, he gets a huge tackle for loss early. That is a statement play.
They'll run it from the gun. Several defenders there to get him on the ground.
I think the OC would have been really happy with a small game and an easier third down. But how about the effort by the running back to get this close? He saw the first down marker, tried to get to it, got close enough now where it's an easy situation on third down. And shoot, and I got fourth down in my pocket if I want to go for it.
Muscling ahead on 3rd and short. Tackle is made after the first down.
You know, this is a running back who wants the ball, and he wants the offense to run through him. Really nice job there on the third down of this opening drive for his offense. I can't wait to see what kind of game this guy's going to have.
Clemson will come to the line with a first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, there's a statement by the defensive line. First down play, expecting run, and they just dominated up front. Beat their one-on-ones and forced a tackle for a loss.
Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. The run up the middle here, looking for a path to the end zone. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
Now listen, the defense won that play. As an offense here, the key, David, you can't go back-to-back negative plays. You got to be smart with the football here. Looks like you're going to have to throw it. You just can't force it. You got to make sure you're playing with that clock in your head. You can't take a sack.
And I think this is a situation where I spread you out. I get more speed on the field. I make the defense declare. I see what they're in, but I'm definitely throwing the football.
They'll run the screen. Jumped on top of the pile. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few. They allowed the completion, but this defense was swarming to keep them away from that first down line.
Yeah, and you allow completions in those third down situations underneath the sticks, and you come up and rally, and everybody flies to the football. That's great execution by this defense.
Splits the uprights, it's good. And the first points of the day come on that field goal.
This is a team that really prides themselves on starting fast. We've seen that before, and here they are playing at home today. Nice job on the opening drive. Lots of poise, good emotion. They don't get the touchdown they would have liked, but they kick a nice field goal. They've got the lead. Head coach has to be happy with that.
After that last field goal drive, they're set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. So NC State's offense has its first opportunity of the day. One way to mitigate the explosive capabilities he has on the outside is be physical with him, and this dude will do that.
He will do that, and you don't see a lot of offenses take the top off this D because of this guy roaming around in the middle of the field. He is a true center fielder, so this receiver's going to have to make plays.
And this just is such a great job of getting guys on the ground. A lot of people are in position, but he makes plays, so him versus a dynamic wide receiver on the outside will be a great matchup.
You can barely hear yourself thinking here as they're trying to get this defense off to a good start. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Yeah, when you get penetration by that defense right away, and there's no way to cut at all for that back, he gets destroyed right away. No way that play was going to be successful. Way too much penetration.
Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise, backing this defense on third down. Looking to throw, it's McCall. On the run, fires downfield. Tosses it incomplete.
Every defense in the country talks about getting offenses in predictable third and long situations where I can bring on more speedsters and I know the pass is coming so I can have more success.
The Wolfpack will line up to punt it away. They'll have to punt for the first time this afternoon. Oh, he got in there and blocked it. Scoops it up on the move. And he's on his way. He'll go all the way. Touchdown, Clemson.
What a big-time play by the punt block team. Great job rushing the punter, understanding where he's trying to kick the football, getting your hand on it, and then how about the scoop and score and do the rest. Big-time special teams play.
They'll try to add another to their lead. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. You don't see this all the time, but when you do, it is such a momentum swing to block, punt, scoop, and score for a touchdown. What a job by the special teams. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. He'll bring it out from inside his own 10. Just never had a chance to shake loose, and he'll be brought down at the 24. North Carolina State has it back in the offense, headed to the field. He'll start this drive firing. Snagged in the middle, it's Concepcion. He's got enough for the first down. They'll spot it at the 37.
And I love the awareness by the wide receiver on that play, because I'm not sure that route was supposed to be that deep. You got to wonder if the receiver decided maybe to adjust the route a little bit to make sure that he got the first down.
He's looking to throw it. Takes a hit as he fires. Right on the money to the outside. He dragged the toe. And how about the ball placement? Only the receiver could get it.
Okay, so they got the completion, but as a quarterback, you really want to avoid taking hits like that. I'm sure it's fine now, but those kind of hits, they can take their toll on you after four quarters.
They'll line up right at the 48-yard line on first and 10. On the ground, it's Waters. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup.
First down. Physicality wins football games. Being able to run the football and create balance. And right here, just chews up another first down, gives you another chance to maybe continue to run the football.
And I feel like this guy, too, is just an explosive play waiting to happen. His vision, his quickness, and he's got a burst. If you give this guy just a crease, he's going to hit it. And right now, he's doing some damage on this defense.
Just about ready to get things started here in the second. We'll see if they continue to flex that muscle. On the option. He'll toss it. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice gain before the defense is able to stop him. Last time these two got together, it was a tight one, Jesse.
Seems like every time these two teams play, the game just feels faster, right? Because it is a rivalry game. There's just a greater sense of urgency when we see these teams match up.
Yeah, the fans feel it. They know it. There's so much to it. They think about it all year long. When you talk about the next game on the schedule, they're always looking forward to this one.
Looking for a man. It's McCall. Receiver looks it in. It's complete. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down.
Hey, listen, as a receiver, you're running that hitch route against man coverage. You can't loaf on it, right? I know it's just a little short throw, but you've got to make the defender think you might be going deep. So a nice job not just taking it easy on the play. He put his foot in the ground, he drove back to the ball, and made it easy on his quarterback.
A little pre-snap eye candy for the defense. He'll take a shot, and it's intercepted. A turnover for the defense. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own.
Well, the defense comes away with the pick there with their nickel personnel. I think moving forward, if you're on offense, when you see that personnel on the field, you want to run the ball against it because you've got smaller guys out there. Or if you're going to throw, think about quick screens outside when you have tight ends flexed on the perimeter, bigger bodies blocking smaller guys.
Clemson ready to dial up some ball plays. They've got it on offense. That last drive was a long one, Jesse. They'd like this time to pay it off with a touchdown instead of a field goal.
No doubt, Reese. They had a lot of good stuff going that last drive. Need to get a tutty up on the board here to extend that lead, Dave.
And I think you definitely want a touchdown, but if you put another long drive together, get points, multiple possessions in a row, start to let those body blows add up and wear this defense out.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Now on the option. He'll toss it. He's loose at the 15. And a big play there on the option. The pitch was executed perfectly. There's an idea that Clemson can only run the ball when they sort of trick you and get you in space, but they're showing a lot of versatility now.
Yeah, I think the word you were looking for was finesse. They've been a finesse offense, more about tempo and body blows than it is about, you know, being physical up front. But if this unit does get that physicality and get that ground game and a good offensive line, I think that's when you see the best of the Clemson Tigers.
And a quick completion, an even quicker loss. The defense was right there to knock him down.
Well, that receiver's looking at his teammates like, guys, what's up? You're not going to block for me on the screen? Seriously? I mean, I just lost yards on a screenplay. How does that happen?
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Caught behind the line. It's Grinding School. And an absolutely fearless tackle. Giving up size, still got him on the turf.
You know, David, this is really what game managing is. Nice pickup on second down to help them on the next play.
Yeah, and I think people look at that negative sometimes, finding a quarterback that's a game manager. No, use your brain. Set up good situations. I'm way more successful when I can keep those sticks at a more manageable situation and I'm not as predictable on a third down.
You got to have short area quickness. That running back there doing what it takes to make sure he got that first down.
The Tigers are on the move. Gets it out fast. After the pickup of 9, it's 2nd and 1.
Nice completion here to this wide receiver, and you're going to see this receiver line up in different spots all over the field all game long. Defense has got to keep their eye on where this guy is because they know he's a big part of this offense's success.
Kept it on the ground last time. Let's see if they go back to it on 2nd down. They'll run it out of the shotgun. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
And you got to do a better job up front right there. That run was doomed from the get-go. Nowhere to go. The back gets hit as soon as he gets the football. Hard to succeed as a running back when you get the ball and you get clobbered.
This has the makings of a good drive. The 7th play brings up a 3rd and 4. To throw, it's Klubnik. Gets open down the middle. Gets it to the 42-yard line, and that's a 1st down. He might have expected to see this DB up in his receiver's kitchen instead. Nice little zone, and they pick up the 1st.
Man, offenses are getting so good, Reese, at seeing the holes in the zone, knowing you're in zone, knowing where to sit down, how to make it an easy pitch and catch for the quarterback, and that's what it was on 3rd and short.
He tried to find some running room, but they get him stopped.
And I can't tell you how much I love seeing corners being willing to come up and tackle. That is so huge for a defense. You can't Olay blocks and create space. You can't just hang out on the outside. You got to go set that edge.
And conversely, I can't tell you how much I hate it when receivers don't want to block. You got to do a better job on the perimeter. It's not going to be enough in this offense just to catch passes. You got to go execute your assignment. That corner should have been blocked, and they should have gotten a bigger gain on that outside run. Well, he's making it look easy out there snagging that pass. Sammy Watkins, Mike Williams, T. Higgins. Great Clemson receivers in recent years. These guys just got open. They found a way with their speed and their route running ability. It's a lot of what this guy does here, too. He makes it easy on his quarterback.
They'll throw it on 1st down. He's got it down the middle. Didn't pick up a lot there. Moved it forward just a few.
Yeah, and that was tough on the DB, right? He's trying to cover the receiver on a drag route, running back over the middle of the field. You're trying to avoid all the linebackers, all the congestion. He just couldn't stay with them long enough, and as a result, fresh set of downs for the offense.
Long drive continues as the offense keeps working the ball down the field. He's looking to throw. And it'll be incomplete. This is some physical pass defense.
My job is to make sure that ball comes loose. And I got to go through that guy, use my shoulder pad, drive my feet, really, really be physical. Because if he bobbles it at all, or as soon as his hand gets to the ball, you can tell the difference when that body jerks forward and that ball starts to come loose and pop out.
Quickly complete. Really confident throw and catch there. Big pickup, and they have a 1st down.
All right, defense. It ain't working, right? They're stringing together several 1st downs here. We're going to need to change this up, find something we can disrupt the quarterback and mess up this offense a little bit.
And the Tigers have it with a 1st and 10. Looking to move it through the air. Got it in the middle. It's Williams. And they pick up just a few on that completion.
And a really nice job by the wide receiver. You run a drag route, find space. They're in zone coverage. They're not covering man-to-man. Find a little hole. Look at that QB. Y'all get on the same page. You could tell they were, and that's why they got the 1st down.
Defense has to be frustrated. The offense keeps matriculating and matriculating and matriculating the ball down the field. And that pass will be jarred loose on 2nd down. That brings up 3rd down.
big tight end tries to make a catch, and you could tell extends for the ball, but great job by the defender getting in there, making the hit, dislodging the football out at the same time as he's going to catch it, and the big tight end couldn't hold on to it.
Looking for a man. It's Klubnik. Got it! And he was dying to push his way in there, but he's knocked down at the three. The clock will stop with this timeout from the offense. They'll get a chance to regroup on the sideline. They've been great on third down. Now to finish the deal on first and goal. They'll try to run it in. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Tigers! Well, 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 somebody's been doing their box jumps.
Ryan, getting up in the air. Hey, listen, I'm taking a picture of that, saving it. That might be my screensaver on my phone, that vertical way up in the air.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. So that was a lengthy 17-play drive and closed the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. They're just about ready to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone, it's Grimes. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. NC State sending the offense back onto the field. To the air on first down. Got his man. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer.
It's hard for an offense to win when you get in predictable situations. What a great job understanding where the first down marker is. Got to get a big gain, got to get that first down. Nice job, great nose for the first down.
We've got a timeout here late in the first half, and they'll try to get more points on the board before the break. After that last completion, it's second down. He's looking to throw. Unloads to the wideout. And the pass is incomplete, jarred loose by the hit. Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off. Dropping back, it's McCall coming after it. Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down. Looks as if NC State will have to punt it away. He hopes this one turns out a little better. Had the other one blocked. Fair catch called for and made. Clemson has their paws on it, and they'll send out the offense. Now you find out just how much of a gunslinger you are. Will you roll the dice here late in the half, David?
And you know the defense is going to be really, really conservative, so I think it's an opportunity to be able to take a shot, see how much of a chunk you can get before then you decide really, Jesse, how you want to finish the half.
You just can't turn it over and throw a pick if you're the quarterback here. You have got to be so smart if you're going to be aggressive with your decision-making.
Trying to find his man on first down. Got his man down the middle. We played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Fellas, what an environment there today. All the animosity and flat-out hatred that comes with a good old-fashioned rivalry game on display in that first half. An entertaining first half, and we've got a multi-possession lead to break down thanks to the surgical precision of this offense. Might honestly take more time to talk about what didn't work than what did. The running game, the passing game, gadget plays have worked. Now it's just a matter of finishing the job. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how this rivalry matchup plays out.
Clemson will kick this deep to get the second half underway. Here he comes from inside his own five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. North Carolina State has it back in the offense, headed to the field. They'll open the second half on the ground. Knocked down after picking up five out to the 24.
All right, they showed this in the first half, right? Loaded up, ran the football, had some success. What do they do in the second half? Come back now, pull some guys, go the other direction, have success. Great job by the coaching staff.
NC State quick to the line. One step wrap, two step squeeze. This junior knows how to get him on the ground. And this offense just can't afford not to get the first down here. Already trailing big, and the clock is not their friend. And it's a live ball. The offense somehow fell on it, and they'll retain possession.
Man, what a break. Great job falling on the football. Great job having some awareness. The running back coughed it up, but teammates there to pick him up, fall on the football. Listen, it's lucky, but it's good job by the offense.
Wolfpack with a first and 10 here. They'll give it to the back. Shakes off the tackler. Pretty good job of running to get two there to the 32.
And a lot of times you want those big plays. You want those splash plays. But sometimes you're going to take some losses. You're not going to run the football overly well. But if you continue to run it, you can at least create some balance. You at least have the threat of it. Otherwise, you're just going to abandon it, and now it's just going to be a passing game.
Motion by the back forces the defense to adjust. Got it behind the line. It's Waters. He's there to make the stop, and they threw it in reverse, losing yardage on that play.
Love the play by the defense. They just did a good job understanding where the running back was on that play. After the catch, they're able to make the tackle right away, and now they've set up third down.
It'll take some work to get to the sticks. It's third and long from the 30. To the air, it's McCall. Looking deep. It's caught. At the 40, there he goes. Touchdown, North Carolina State. Hauled it in and just kept right on running to the hallelujah land.
Man, how hard is it to defend when you have a weapon like this at running back that can play wide receiver? You can design ways to get the football in his hand. Palmer, once you get it in his hands, he'll do the rest.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, and oftentimes those are easier throws for quarterbacks. And these running backs, they're just naturally so good when they have the football out in space. Their vision, their creativity, their ability to make people miss. And this guy showed you right there, a difficult, difficult guy to stop now if you're this defense moving forward.
Lining up for the PAT. And with the extra point, they closed to within 10, down 17-7. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And the points come in a lightning strike, a 70-yard touchdown pass. So they've got the lead down to 10 here. A little more interesting as they're set to kick it away. Let's see if he can make a play on the return. Good job by the coverage unit to put a stop to that return. Clemson ready to dial up some ball plays. They've got it on offense. Things have been clicking along nicely, Jesse, but they have to make sure they keep it up.
Yeah, they got to wake up. It seems like they've been a bit lackadaisical here the last few drives, maybe, as we've seen this lead dwindle a little bit, David. So they need a bit of a spark here to get that mojo back.
Yeah, and you always have the adjustments, and then your opponent adjusts, and now they got to readjust now because this game's getting a little bit tighter than they liked.
Now on first down from the 28. The give to the back. Still running at the 40. Stopped at the 42, but he got 15 yards on the play.
Man, who says you can't run up the middle anymore, right? Everybody thinks, I got to make big plays. I got to go way out to the left, way out to the right, way out in space. Nope, right down the middle. Nice blocking. How about the running back? You could tell the speed, the wheels, does a great job getting down the field, making a huge rushing play.
Dropping back, it's Klubnik. Throws to the wideout. Finds a man on the left. Lots of green grass as he gets it to the 31. This guy has the look of the next big play receiver at Clemson in the vein of T. Higgins or Mike Williams.
or DeAndre Hopkins or Sammy Watkins. I mean, the list is pretty lengthy of guys that are big, explosive, fast, and they can really win on the outside. And Clemson, as much as anybody, they're going to catch the ball, spit it to those guys, let them go make plays.
Wants to throw on first down. Catch in the middle, it's Brown. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down.
And that's a really good example of why offensive coordinators script plays. You know the down and distance, and you know which routes can get you to the stick. So there's no wasted time. That coordinator got the play in early to his quarterback, knowing that his players were going to be able to execute.
Motion, trying to get the defense to show his hand. Caught in the backfield, it's Maffa. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there. Well, he made the grab, but the doors closed quickly after that.
And I like this. I want to find my running back, but, man, he's got to do a little more damage after the catch. I need a stiff arm. I need a spin move. I need something where he can make that guy miss and pick up a bunch of yards and maybe get a big play out of it.
And his throw is incomplete.
Yeah, a nice job by the defense understanding who their go-to guy is. That's the guy they want to feature. That's the guy they want to feed with good reason. He's a great player, but a great job by the defense taking away that primary read, making sure they don't make a big play.
They'd love to pick up this third down and get a fresh set with first and goal. On third down, he drops the throw. Pulls it in the end zone. Touchdown, Clemson! They've extended this lead, guys, but sometimes in a rivalry game, you get down and you fight back that much harder.
Man, you've seen crazy comebacks and crazy swings of momentum in rivalry games. You just need that first thing to break your way, Palmer.
I think it really comes down to their key playmakers, Dave, and they can come back. But these guys need to take ownership. Now's the time. In this type of game, they have got to step up and start making plays.
Getting set for the point after. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. So a drive there of 85 yards, and they top it off with a 14-yard pass for the touchdown. Just about set to kick it away. On the run from inside his own five. Couldn't find a way to create that broken field as he stopped at the 25. NC State sending the offense back onto the field. After giving up that score, now it's incumbent on this offense to kind of get a back and forth going, Jesse, in this game.
They got to put some points on the board here. There's obviously a lot of football to go, so it's not necessarily panic time just yet, but I'm getting the ball into the hands of my best playmakers on this drive.
I hear you, Jesse, but not panic time. Have you seen my defense? I mean... I'm not trusting them to get a lot of stops, so he puts a lot of pressure on this offense.
Looking for space, it's Waters. Defense there to stop him after a gain of 1 to the 22. And this offense can ill afford to come up empty on this drive, already trailing by multiple possessions. He hurls one deep down the left side. And the DB forcing the incomplete pass with the deflection.
Well, at this juncture in the game, with how the scoreboard looks, no question this offense is going to have to throw to get back in the game. And it's going to be tricky now because the defense is expecting it. You're going to throw into a lot of big zone coverages with everybody's eyes on the quarterback. Not going to be easy.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. No return coming here. Fair catch is signaled for and made just shy of the 30. Clemson has their paws on it, and they'll send out the offense. Cross the 30 out to the 33 and gains 4 on the play.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down. It's 2nd and 6. Hand off to the lone back. Still on his feet at the 45. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
You don't always have to run the sexy plays, right? It doesn't have to always be up-tempo and fast and spread and doing all this stuff. Sometimes you just lower your shoulder. Sometimes you just run powerfully. You get the first down, and that's all that matters.
How about that play to get a hand in there and force the incompletion?
In football, you hear the term quick, but don't hurry. And you could tell when you run these RPOs, the QBs want to make that decision quick. And I think he hurried it a little bit too much, got the ball out quick, but obviously was inaccurate with his pass.
Here comes the offense on second down. Looking downfield, it's Klubnik. Fires to the right. And it'll be incomplete. This defense is physical in pass deep.
Unfortunate with that incompletion. The quarterback and his intended target not on the same page.
A third and long coming up here. From the gun, wants to pass. Got it in the middle, it's Brown. This defense giving up ground as he's finally knocked down at the 26.
Well, offensive coordinators put in countless hours every week trying to formate and use different personnel groupings and shifts and motions to give their offenses success on third down. You can tell in this game, this offensive coordinator, he has put in the work this week.
This Clemson offense moving quickly down the field. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. And they get the sack just like that.
When it's a play action pass, that quarterback, he really has to sell the fake. He can't tell his offensive lineman's getting beat right away while he's selling the fake. He had no shot.
So now on second and long, you start to think just don't fall out of field goal range. He's looking to throw. Grabbed in the backfield. It's Maffa. And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage. We've come to the end of the quarter, and Clemson has the lead. They built a comfortable lead after three quarters of play. Let's take a look at how we got here. Just about ready to go in the fourth, and we'll see if any drama can be mustered. Seventh play of the drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. It's fourth down, and they'll try the field goal. Well, they've already made one. The holder will put it down at the 38 for a 48-yard attempt. Right down the boulevard, it's good. And that lead grows even bigger. They're really starting to extend that lead as they get ready to kick it away again. On the move from inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. North Carolina State has it back in the offense, headed to the field. Gets it out quickly. A 7-yard pickup. It'll be second and three.
Here's the deal. You're down three possessions. You know, it doesn't feel likely they're going to come back and win, but we've seen crazier stuff happen in college football. It all starts with a big completion on a 2-minute drive. They'll get the momentum started in your direction.
And here comes the offense on second down. Wants to throw. It's McCall. And he really needed to hold on to that one, but it was not loose, and third down is coming.
It's really hard to win football games when you're one-dimensional offensively, and that's the case. They just have not been able to get anything going, throwing it deep down the field. They haven't won their one-on-one matchups. Quarterback has missed some throws, and as a result, in the fourth quarter, they barely have 100 yards passing, and that's why they're losing.
Grabbed in the middle. It's Concepcion. And he's tripped up, but not before picking up the first down.
When you're a playmaker like this guy is, your coaches are going to dial up plays intended for you, especially on third down. That's what you saw in that last play. There was no question where the quarterback was going with that football. All week long, they decided on the biggest downs of this game, we're going to target our best player, and we're going to make sure that he gets looks. It doesn't matter what the coverage is, and you saw it right there on that play.
And they're able to force him out of bounds after a short pickup.
It's hard to run a route or get lost near the sidelines and understand exactly where you're at. Nice job understanding I was starting to get close to the sidelines, throttling down a little bit, catching the football, and making sure I was in bounds.
Looking to throw on second down. Floating away. Trying to escape and get it himself. They'll get him on the ground at the 46, and it'll be a first down.
Well, he does a really nice job buying time, and I love the awareness there, understanding no one's open downfield, knowing where the sticks are, and he's able to use his athleticism to get that first down.
NC State with a first and 10 here. He wants to throw. Catch in the middle. It's Concepcion. Tackle is made at the 44, but he picked up 10 yards and enough for a first down.
This defense better not blink. I know they've got a lead here in the fourth quarter, but just look at who they're going against. This quarterback is one of the best in the nation. They cannot rest on their laurels. Someone's going to have to make a play.
Now they'll line it up from the 44 on first and 10. He's going to pass. Caught over the middle. It's Grimes. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain.
This offense has their work cut out for them, man, because the coverage has been so tight. And if you're not throwing to the sideline or you're not getting past the sticks, this defense is going to tackle you inbounds like they just did on that last play and bleed the clock.
Offense about to reel off its seventh play of the drive. Fires to the wideout. Just missed his man, gave him just a little too much.
And that's just the kind of game it's been for this quarterback and this offense. You got a great game plan all week long. You're watching it throughout practice. You think you're going to have a chance to light up the scoreboard, but they're just not able to hook up. You've got to give this defense a ton of credit. They've done a great job in coverage. They've been breaking on passes. They've had their number, and that's why they're leading by as much as they are.
Grabbed over the middle. It's Concepcion. Excellent job working through the air there, finding a hole in that defense and picking up a first down. We asked earlier this week, who's your favorite receiver? And of course, he said the open one, but we know who he really wants to go to on third down.
The best one. I mean, I think the open one, obviously the politically correct answer, but you want to find the guy that you got that great chemistry with. You know exactly where he's going to be. You got that bond and that trust.
And he runs through one tackle and picks up a few.
Defense, man, you got to go low and you got to chop that tree down, right? Go with the legs. Take the legs out from underneath them so he can't continue to churn those puppies out and get extra yards after contact like he did there.
Going to work in the red zone, they can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. Plows through the defense. Obliterates him, still on the move. They make the tackle, but he's got a fresh set of downs and it's first and goal from the 7.
You know, you start day one of training camp running your base runs. You need a few yards, you run these plays. You need a first down, you run these plays. You rep them over and over and over again. They're not sexy, they're not pretty, but in the end, they're effective, and they get you that new set of downs when you need them.
Back to throw, it's McCall. Touchdown, NC State! And they'll put that scoreboard operator to work and put 6 on the board. PAT unit on the field. bangs it through for an extra point. They put it in the end zone with a 12-play scoring drive. And they close the deal with the 7-yarder for the score. They still have work to do, trailing by 2 possessions here in the fourth. They'll line up for the onside kick. Cool as a cucumber as the hands team makes a sure catch. Clemson ready to dial up some ball plays. They've got it on offense. Jesse, they had to kick a field goal the last time they had it.
Yeah, and oftentimes early in games, you're just trying to find your rhythm. Some things work, some don't on that first drive, David. It'd be interesting to see what happens here on the second drive.
Yeah, you got a feel for the defense now. You understand what they're trying to do, what their game plan is. Now you get to go into phase 2 of your game plan.
After the misfire, now on second down. They'll keep it on the ground, trying to milk the clock. Across the 25, he's got room. And they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play.
Yeah, defensively, you better be ready to run east and west when you're playing against this offense. In their running game, that time, the offense was able to outflank the defense to the right side for a big play.
The Tigers want to pick up the tempo. They'll give it to him again. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
And this is a perfect situation. This is a situation, if you asked me to be in before the game, the coaches would have been in heaven. I got the football. I got the lead on their side of the field. Nice gain on first down. Same exact script. Do it again. Run the football. Run the clock. Let that thing tick down. And if we add points, we add points.
Keeping it on the ground with the running back. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and this offense is that much closer to salting away a victory. The terrain gets rough this deep in the red zone. Third down, they can pick up the first without scoring. Looking to throw, it's Klubnik. He caught it, and he will score! Touchdown, Tigers!
There's no mercy rule in college football, man. They've got a huge lead here in the fourth quarter. They are still chucking it, and they are still scoring.
They'll line up to go for 2. Trying to pound it in. He's not going to make it. Stop short of the goal line, and they are unable to extend this lead any further. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. And the returner will be knocked down. NC State sending the offense back onto the field. Not a lot of hope here, down 3 possessions late.
Now, and I love this part as a pass rusher because I'm just pinning my ears back, getting to the quarterback. I know it's a pass every single time. Palmer, I'm trying to pad my stats. I'm sure you're just trying to stay up with it.
Well, we're definitely just trying to stay alive at this point, but you're also trying to build confidence, too, for your next opponent. If you can find some completions late in the game, even though it looks like you're going to lose it, it's all about...
And the defense makes a play, sacking him back at the 10.
And I tell you what, this defense, they've heard all about how great this quarterback is. They came in today with a mission, with a purpose. They've been flying around, harassing him, and making life so hard on this offense.
Now they've got to hustle to the line and get set. On 3rd and long, no secret what he needs here. A deep throw as the clock winds down. Oh, and it's a pick. He threw it right into the double coverage. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
Heat up them pass rushers, bring in them DBs. That's what I'm doing in this situation. When I got the lead by a couple scores late in the ballgame, in the fourth quarter, I'm going to rush the passer like crazy. I'm going to put all those DBs back playing the pass. That's what happened. Great job understanding they're going to have to take shots. We get the interception. This one's almost over.
Clemson has their paws on it, and they'll send out the offense. What a feeling this has to be, David, in complete control and headed toward victory formation.
Yeah, no stress, under a couple minutes left in the ball game, well in hand. These are the ones, Jesse, you like to just run the clock, take a knee, whatever you want.
No doubt. They're going to love watching this game film, too. There's just so many positives to take away from this, and this is the kind of performance today that is really going to help this offense's confidence.
Lost five on that first play, and now it's second and 15. The give from the gun. Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore.
This offensive line better figure out a plan for this D tackle. He is tough to block with one guy. You might want to start double teaming him. He's going to be a problem moving forward. You saw all of his ability on that last play.
With the clock running, this should be the final play. Thank you.